Dear students, there are certain kind of situations where we have two sample data sets and we are going to compare that whether the slopes of the two regression lines are they identical or they are different from each other. So sometimes we make use of the F test to compare that the slope of the two regression models they are identical to each other. But we consider that the two populations are normal. That means the data of the two samples, it is being drawn from the normal populations. But in case the populations are non-normal, we can make use of the non-parametric alternative approaches. So in this particular case, where the test is to compare the two parallel regression lines. So Hollander has proposed a procedure to test that whether the two regression coefficients or the slopes of the two lines are identical to each other. So students, this particular test that was proposed by Hollander, it is actually based on the Wilcoxon test. So usually if our objective is to test that for two data sets, the slope of the two regression models are identical. In these particular situations, we require to test that the two kind of data sets, are they having the same slopes or whether the slopes are different. So let me share one example where we can make use of the test for parallelism of the two regression lines. A psychologist may wish to test that the linear relationship between depression and performance is same for men and women. So students, here you can see that the objective is to compare the depression level and the performance that is to be related for the two kind of samples, one for the men and other for the women. So in such situation, the test for equality of slopes of the population regression lines are referred to as test for homogeneity of slopes. So we can actually call them as being homogeneity or the equality of slopes, or they are popularly called as test for parallelism of two regression lines. So in parametric statistics, we can make use of the T or F test to compare the equality or the homogeneity of the slopes. Whereas in case that the parent populations from which the samples are being drawn are non-normal, we can make use of the non-parametric alternative approach, which was proposed by Hollander in 1970. So this test is actually a distribution-free test, and it is based on Wilcoxon signed rank test, using which we can test the homogeneity of slopes of the two regression models. Hollander test, students, it requires that the number of pairs of data in the two data sets, they must be equal and even. In case that the two data sets are not equal or they are not even, we would have to make them even, or we would have to take them equal by randomly discarding the observations from one of the samples which is showing the greater number of observations. So this test is actually the variation of a Wilcoxon matching pair signed rank test. The Hollander statistic is applicable even if the two regression lines do not share the same regression coefficients. However, this technique requires us to group capital N by two pairs of regression constants for each line. So using the grouping scheme proposed by the Hollander, it reduces the variance of the slope estimates when compared with all grouping schemes that have identically distributed the slope estimates. In order to apply the Hollander method for testing the parallelism of two regression lines, that means the homogeneity of the two regression slopes, there are certain assumptions that are to be met under the Hollander's method. The first assumption that we need to consider is that the data consists of two sets of observations. For each, the model yj equal to alpha plus beta xj plus epsilon j is assumed to be appropriate, where xj's are fixed constants, they are known to us, and alpha and beta are the unknown parameters, and yj is a value of the random variable y observed at a fixed point xj. Then the next assumption that we need to consider under the Hollander method is that the errors are mutually independent of each other. That means E1 is independent of E2, E3 and so on, EN. Similarly, the rest of the errors are also mutually independent. For each line, the errors are being drawn from the same continuous populations, but the two populations do not have to be the same.